Talk about a U-turn. In just a few short months, North Korean leader Kim Jong Un has gone from launching intercontinental ballistic missiles to meeting with world leaders. How did that happen? It all comes down to one word: denuclearization. Basically, much of the world wants Kim to give up his nuclear arsenal, an arsenal he's been building for most of his 6 years in power. Would he actually do that?
I think the recent comments, mostly coming from South Korea, about North Korea's willingness to discuss denuclearization, actually missed the point.
That's Allison Evans. She analyzes Asia-Pacific security risks.
North Korea has said it's willing to discuss denuclearization when security on the peninsula is guaranteed. And I think that's what we need to focus on how the definition of denuclearization differs between North Korea and the other parties.
Evans says Kim has one goal: to stay in power. He sees the American nuclear umbrella as a real threat. Nuclear weapons are like an insurance policy, giving North Korea leverage over more powerful enemies like the U.S. So what would it take for denuclearization to go from just talk to reality?
There are probably smaller scale things that North Korea might request behind closed doors, but ultimately North Korea would be seeking things like a peace treaty with the United States and or South Korea.
Kim announced he's stopping nuclear tests and scaling back his missile program. But to go farther, analysts say he'll expect big concessions from President Trump. What could those be? Guarantees he'll stay in power, for one. Also, relief from sanctions and even normalized relations with the U.S. if Kim agrees to take verifiable steps towards denuclearization.
First of all, I don't think that North Korea is anywhere near giving up its nuclear weapons at this stage. I think there would be sort of first steps towards denuclearization that might happen first. First and foremost, it would be stopping operations at a light water reactor in North Korea. Another example would be allowing IAEA inspectors in to look at North Korea's nuclear facilities. Those kind of things are likely to happen first along the way.
I've been to Pyongyang many times. All over the city, there's propaganda celebrating North Korea as a nuclear power. They even had it written into their constitution. Denuclearization would mean a huge cultural shift. And even if North Korea does agree to denuclearize, there's just so much we don't know about their arsenal. How many nuclear weapons? In how many locations? And how many more nukes could North Korea make if a deal with the U.S. falls apart?